The most challenging moments of my life have consistently sparked personal growth. 2 years ago, I hit what felt like rock bottom. Nicotine, alcohol. It's only now I realize how finite life is. That's why I started living it on my own terms. So let me ask you this. Are you spending every day of your life doing what you love? Because many of us aren't, either because we do not know what to do, or just feel so lost in a world full of distractions, living our lives on autopilot, dictated by our routines. Wake up, breakfast, school, home, sleep. Expectations by others, but not by ourselves. And this lack of awareness leads us to unconsciously never self-discover what we want in life. Because we focus on what others are doing, losing touch with our own lives. Is this life truly mine? It's easy to follow a path set by others. Go to school, get a job, retire. And if you want to live like this, that's fine. However, I couldn't bear it. I always asked myself, does this path resonate with who I am? The average person spends about 79 years on Earth. And if we represent each year of a life with a skittle, we can see how we use up our lives. A big chunk goes into sleeping, about 26 years. And that is a third of our life. And then there is work. On average, we spend about 13 years of our life working. And add to that the hours we spend looking at our screen, around 11 years. But here's a catch. This doesn't include school time, exercising, or even eating. After accounting for everything, we are left with barely 8 years to self-discover ourselves. And just like that, your time is up. When I first heard about this statistic, it made me rethink everything, because there's nothing more dangerous than live your life as others want you to. I always remembered every single time I went through suffering and hardship, it has led me to the light, learning from my mistakes and bettering myself. And I'll give you an example from my life. When I was 12 years old, I would go for runs every single day because I loved it. However, there was one night where everything changed. I was going for a run and a car tried to hit me. It tried to hit me again and again. So I sprinted away from the area. And as I was sprinting away, they left their cars and started to chase me, not knowing what intentions they had with me. I ran as fast as I could until they stopped chasing me. That night, I could not sleep in my own bed, full of fear of death. That was the last day I felt fear. And to this day, I do not fear anything. It made me self-discover myself. I don't want anyone to be in the same situation as I was. However, what I learned that day is that only pain and suffering can lead me into the light, going out of your comfort zone, exploring new places, talking to new people. All these are ways that lead to self-discovery. Realizing that supposedly we only have 8 years to live, it didn't make me sad, but motivated me to find myself in uncomfortable places. If you cut out screen time, you will earn 11 years back of your lifetime. It's important to realize that social media doesn't give us anything in life, and it only takes our time on the clock until you have none left. It's easy to get lost in a never-ending scroll, wasting our precious days, weeks, months, and years. These devices and social media that isn't social anymore takes our attention throughout the day. Don't forget to like this video so you help others find this video too. However, there is an invisible pull towards mindless activities. This internal conflict leads to guilt, and we try to escape this feeling by diving deeper into distractions. And the more you distract yourself, the more you know less of yourself. No time for self-discovery, and no time to know what you love doing. And it feels like forever until you find the part of yourself who is motivated to do anything and tries his best all the time. So instead of distracting yourself with mindless activities, sit and ask yourself questions. Instead of saying, "I don't know what to do," or "I don't know where to start," as these are statements that close your mind from thinking, instead ask yourself this: what can I do right now to start a path of self-discovery? Or what can I do today to go out of my comfort zone? As going out of your comfort zone is where you usually find purpose in life. Asking a question to yourself and take action. However, it's easier said than done. Taking action for most is the hardest thing to start with. This is why you must get comfortable with the uncomfortable. If you're constantly seeking new challenges, pushing boundaries, and stepping outside of your comfort zone, when was the last time you felt truly alive? It probably was when you were in discomfort or suffering. And to my understanding, being uncomfortable is addictive. People like this don't deal with challenges. However, they want to be uncomfortable all the time. For me, it was starting a new YouTube channel, talking about my emotions, feelings, and life experiences, which are difficult to talk to, as I know people who know me watch this. Going to networking events and talking to new people, training every day, even if I hate training. These challenges were tough, but I enjoyed them, and they taught me a lot. You have to challenge yourself, even if you don't like it. Sometimes we feel sad, angry, or even happy. And yes, I feel sad sometimes. However, I live my life to the exact second, as I don't know what will happen tomorrow. Maybe the days of my life runs out, and I won't be on this earth anymore. And usually people take this for granted. I don't. I know I will try my best all the time. I know I am the best I have ever been, because I went through destroying myself to the point where there was nothing left, and found self-love, self-discovery, and built on that, which created the man I am today. If you want to know the 3 ways to waste your teenage years, click here to watch this video.
I have to do this 980 times, and I'm just about 520 in. Why is this so hard?